transport.
So, Mr. B, what's the word in these?
Pheromones, Michael. You know, the latest scientific research shows that pheromones have a great deal to do with sexual attraction.
Sounds very interesting.
Sign us up.
Hector, it's 3:30. We don't get paid for overtime.
Oh, I know, Leslie. But the kids need me here. Only 2 weeks to the science fair.
Look out!
Try it again, Mendel. A tad less sulfuric acid.
School?
Ha-ha, still the same old hand, huh?
No. You are looking at the biggest distributor of dog tranquilizers west of Chicago. It's like a license to print money. I can't believe I wasted 9 years in this place.
You weren't a bad science teacher, Gus.
Vargas, wake up and smell the formaldehyde, man. I am pulling down $100,000 a year. You're still doing lunch duty.
Yeah, but I have excellent benefits.
Oh, Hector.
Terrific hours.
Hector.
Summer's off.
Hector, spare me, please. I remember when we started out together. You were going to teach a couple of years and then go into research. What was that vitamin thing you were into?
Vitamin absorption and intelligence. I still have my notes.
There you go. Oh, I bet you hear that in your sleep, huh?
I have to go, Gus.
All right, listen, I'm in town till Thursday. Stop by my hotel. I have a suite. We'll have a few drinks. We'll talk about the bad old days.
I don't think so.
Gus, you really upset him.
What'd I say?
Yeah, Mr. V, man, we have got our science project all planned out.
It's about pheromones. You know how certain odors can attract females? According to his book, if we isolate this stuff and boil it down...
Not now, boys.
I just can't stop thinking about him, you know? I mean, the more I start thinking about him, the more he starts looking like Corey Hart. And it's like he moves like Brishnikov.
Two of your finest, por favor.
On the stick and make it quick.
Do you boys have any money?
Okay, that's 38 cents. What is this?
That's my tooth. I was looking for that.
He's back. Look. Stace, go get him. I'll cover for you.
What if he has a girlfriend? You know,
he'll leave her for you. Now go.
Oh.
We have our dogs now.
Are you a righty or a lefty?
Excuse me.
Well, I'm so embarrassed.
Why?
Did you talk to him?
I couldn't.
Why not?
He was buying a jock strap.
Stacy, couldn't you have worked it into the conversation?
This is so boring.
Wait.
Excuse me, Vargas. Not now, Arnold. This is a critical point.
This is a fiasco.
Not if the mouse turns right.
Damn!
Vargas, the science fair is your shining moment. You can't be proud of this. The science fair is kid stuff, Arnold. This research is my ticket out of here.
You're a teacher. You have a job to do.
What's the point? The kids, they come and go, and we're stuck here. Do you know that Pentelis used to borrow my lesson plans? Now he makes $100,000 a year.
Maybe we should go talk to Mr. Vargas.
Doesn't care. Watch this.
Mr. Vargas, can I dissect Spicoli?
Sure. Just keep it down.
I am not an animal.
It's the elephant man.
Hi, Stacy.
Hi, Mark.
I've seen the ending like 27 times. See, that's when we get ready to clean up for the next show. Would you like to see it with me sometime? I could get us passes.
But you've seen the ending 27 times.
Well, if I see the beginning, then I'll finally understand it.
Mark, I'm sorry. I gotta go, okay?
Hey, little sister, what have you done?
Excuse me.
Hey, little sister, who's the only one?
Excuse me.
Hey, little sister, who's
your
Superman?
Can I help you?
No, I was just looking at your car.
I've seen you before.
Yeah, I work here at the mall.
That must be it. So what's your name?
Tracy.
Hi, Tracy. I'm Brent.
Hi.
So, would you like to get some dinner or something?
I don't know.
Well, I'm leaving town tomorrow, so, maybe some other time, huh?
Dinner sounds great.
Terrific. Hop in.
Okay.
So, Tracy, tell me about yourself.
Some extra secret sauce on that burger, it can be arranged.
Mm.
Or maybe a nice juicy slice of tomato.
Brad, have you seen Stacy? We were supposed to go shopping.
No, she hasn't been in here.
According to Rat, Stacy went off with a strange guy.
What?
Tell him, Rat.
Stacy went off with a strange guy.
How strange?
I don't know him. He called her Tracy.
This woman leads a double life.
It's two more than you're gonna have.
Was he real good looking? Great dresser?
Yeah, a regular action figure.
Yeah? I can't believe it, she did it! This is so exciting.
You know, I should have gotten that license number.
What kind of car did you drive?
Wait a minute. She got into a car with him?
What, is she crazy? How could she do that?
Brad, take it easy. She met a cute guy, they went out, it's no big deal.
No big deal? There are kidnappers out there looking for girls just like Stacy to sell them into slavery. That's all they do, all day long.
And then, when I flunked out of med school, I said to myself, hey, Brent, hey, guy, I mean, what are you going to do with your life? And that's when I made a very important decision.
Really?
I decided to go into aviation.
You're a pilot?
No, I'm a flight attendant.
A stewardess?
I can't tell you how much I hate it when people say that.
So you travel a lot. That must be great.
Yeah, right now, I'm on the shuttle service from Tucson to Burbank.
Turn right, Waldo. Dang. It was so close.
Hector? Hi, I saw your light on. Oh, my. Don't you rest anymore?
I've wasted enough of my life, Leslie.
Don't the mice have to sleep? Just teasing.
Hand me that feeding bottle, would you? I've been feeding Waldo a new vitamin supplement. If he can get through the maze in less than a minute, I really may be onto something.
Hector, listen, I have to ask you something, and it's probably not even any of my business, but... Why did you cancel the science fair?
I've come to an important decision, Leslie. I've given in my resignation.
Why? I mean, I don't understand. What are you saying? You're a wonderful teacher, Hector.
No. I need to get out into the world. I need to do something with my life. I need to make my mark before it's too late. Okay, Waldo. Drink that down now. and you grow up to be big and strong and intelligent, and all the other mice will want to be just like you.
Brad, you're overreacting.
It's my little sister out there.
He's probably a very nice guy.
Why? Because he's a good dresser?
Yeah, partly.
Jack the Ripper was a good dresser.
Jack the Ripper was a terrible dresser.
You encouraged her, didn't you?
I was just trying to help her come out of her shell.
Why? What was wrong with her shell? It was a perfectly good shell.
You know, Linda, if anything happens to her, you're going to have to live with it.
Brad.
What?
Where are you going? Come on, if it'll make you feel any better, let's go back upstairs, we'll make a few phone calls, and we'll track her down.
She'll be fine.
Yeah, she'll be fine.
I mean, the passengers don't realize. If we spent all of our time fluffing pillows, who's going to serve the coffee?
I never thought of that.
Hey, you, sure you don't want a margarita? I mean, they're really primo here.
No. Do you like the Thompson twins?
Oh, I'm not from around here.
No, they're a group. I mean, they're not even twins, really. There are three of them.
You know, you are really very cute. You know that?
No, I'm not.
Yes, you are.
No.
Hey, I bet you work out, right?
In gym. When I go to the gym.
You know, I've got a rowing machine at my house that could be in the Museum of Modern Art.
Huh?
I'll show it to you. We'll go back to my place. Check.
Would you excuse me, please? I have to go to the ladies' room.
Sure.
Honey, you're not going to believe this, but they've got me working late again. Sweetheart, baby, what can I do? I mean, if you could see the stack of paper piled here on my desk. Honey, I don't hear people in the background. Oh, it must be the cleaning lady. Could you keep it down? I'm talking to my wife. And how much longer? Oh, my. Oh, sweetheart.
Okay, Waldo, this is it. I know you can do it. Go. Come on, Waldo, turn right. Yes, go, go, go! You did it, Waldo! You did it!
Do you see what I mean? I think he's lost it.
Arnold, what are you doing here?
Well, I heard you were thinking of resigning.
Onward and upward.
Well, I just dropped by to wish you luck. Oh, is this part of your research?
Yes, have a look.
Is this mouse dead?
Huh?
Oh, Hector, I'm so sorry.
Who am I kidding? You can't do serious work in a high school science lab. Maybe if I would have started 15 years ago. I don't know.
Can I share something with you? I've kept this scrapbook over the years.
If you brought that out to depress me, Arnold, you're too late.
Here you are, Vargas, when you first started.
Look how long your hair was.
And there you are, Leslie, in the parking lot.
Oh, look, there's my old Volvo. Why did I ever lend that car to that girl?
You see this boy? That's Potato Head Lewis, the original Spicoli.
Why do they call him Potato Head? Oh my.
I failed Potato twice before he finally passed my class. Now he's an engineer with three little spuds running around.
Oh, that's nice.
Ah, the Brill twins.
Oh, now they're pretty.
And they understood the Taft-Hartley Act.
I saw them in a pantyhose commercial.
They modeled to pay their way through law school. Now they share an office at the Justice Department.
Hmm.
Oh, look, there's Bess Hopper. You know, she won the science fair 3 years in a row. Wonder what ever happened to her.
Oh, I had a letter from her just last month. She's working as a pediatrician in Seattle.
I didn't know you kept all this stuff.
It reminds me of an old adage. A teacher affects eternity.
Eternity, huh?
Stick around, Hector.
We're going to need some more coffee.
to the noblest profession.
Ew.
Hey, what are you doing out here?
Chasing after the perfect guy?
No. There's no perfect guys, only perfect waves. Am I right?
Yeah!
Pile on in, it's a fiesta on wheels.
Word yet? I guess not.
Relax, okay? I told you, if I hear anything, I'll let you know. I'm calling my parents.
They'll ground her for a year.
Listen, it was you who started this whole... Hello, Cattleburger. Stacy? Well, where are you? Are you at home? Oh, thank God. She's home.
Let me talk to her.
Do you mind? She's my sister. Yeah, sure. She's right here.
Stace, hi. Was he a dream? Ooh, good scary or bad scary? I never told you to get into a car with him. Yeah, I can see him from here. He's right next to me. Okay. She wants to talk to Mark.
Hello? Oh, no, that's okay. No, you didn't insult me. Really? Yeah. No, I don't mind seeing it for the 28th time. Sure. Okay. Yes!
Keep an eye on Waldo Jr. Call me if he falls in love. So, how's it going?
Oh, it's working out great. Thanks, Mr. Vargas.
Carry on.
Plus, Mr. Television Milton Berle tomorrow on the CBS Morning News. Later tonight, she was lured by Lady Luck. But when she began to lose, it was only the beginning. Valerie Bertinelli stars...